A very good morning to all the students. Here in this tutorial, we're going to begin with our sixth lesson, My Childhood, written by APJ Abdul Kalam. I would like to welcome you back here again to your tutorials and the same procedure that we have been following for past many months. There are some feedback that I would like to give you of your half-yearly exams. The question answers that I had given you, I found that most of you have copied it. Especially if I talk about the story writing and the paragraph writing that I had given you, it was totally copied. I had not accepted that and I will not in future. Students, let me be very clear that if you are going to copy like this, this will not going to help you at all. Until and unless you write it all by yourself. I know that you will face problem in the beginning, but as soon as you practice it, you'll definitely going to progress and you'll definitely going to improve in your writing ability. And yes, question answers, I found that questions were different and the answers that you had written were totally different. Please try and understand that before attempting any question, you need to understand the real meaning, what is the question that is being asked by the teacher. So students, from next time, I would like you to go through the questions first. That what is being asked, then you write the answers. Don't be in hurry. Don't be in hurry at all. Understand it, then write it down. Yes, there are the things, there are certain things where you need to improve. Of course, in writing ability, definitely. Short question answers, long question answers. I'll be discussing them in the upcoming tutorials, don't worry. But you yourself need to make out that what are the points or where are the things that you need to work on. Let's begin with the lesson, My Childhood, written by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. First, let's read about him. The full form of APJ is Abul Pakir Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam, born on 15th October 1931 and died on 27 July 2015. He was an Indian aerospace scientist and politician who served as the 11th President of India from 2002 to 2007. He was born and raised in Rameswaram, Tamil Nadu, and studied physics and aerospace engineering. On 27 July 2015, Kalam travelled to Shillong to deliver a lecture on creating a livable planet Earth at the Indian Institute of Management, Shillong. At around 6:35 p.m. only, 5 minutes into his lecture, he collapsed. He was rushed to the nearby Bethany Hospital in a critical condition. Upon arrival, he lacked a pulse or any other signs of life. Kalam was confirmed dead of a sudden cardiac arrest in the hospital. So this is how he died. What is APJ Abdul Kalam known for? What he basically is known for? APJ Abdul Kalam served as the President of the Republic of India from 2002 to 2007. He promoted the advancement of the National Nuclear Weapons Program. He also devised a 20-year action plan to achieve economic growth through technological development in India. He won many awards both from the Indian government and from the international community. His most notable awards were the Padma Shri Padma Vibhushan, won in 1990, and the Bharat Ratna, the highest civilian award, won in 1996. 1997. So here is a lesson from your book. Let's first read out before you read.
Can you think of any scientist who have also been a statesman? What is a statesman first? Statesman, an experienced politician who has earned public interest. An important and experienced politician who has earned public interest. So is there any scientist who have also been statesmen other than Mr. APJ Abdul Kalam? Think about it and just write it down in your book. APJ Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space, defense and nuclear technology guided India into the 21st century, became our 11th president in 2002. In his autobiography, Wings of Fire, he speaks of his childhood. So students, basically, this chapter, My Childhood, has been taken from Wings of Fire. Wings of Fire is a book, is an autobiographical book written by APJ Abdul Kalam himself. So this is just a small extract that has been taken from his book. In this book, Wings of Fire, he has talked about his childhood memories. APJ Abdul Kalam, he had his projects in space, defense and nuclear technology. With his help, with his guidance, India, went into the 21st century, and he became the 11th president in 2002 and served to 2007. Let's begin. I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameswaram in the erstwhile Madras state. My father, Jainulabdin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. So here APJ Abdul Kalam says that he was born into a middle class family, belonged to a middle class Tamil family, where he was born in an island town of Rameswaram. Earlier it was known as Madras. His father's name is Jainulabdin. Though his father had not had much education, nor he had much wealth, but despite these advantages, despite not having much education and wealth, he had great innate wisdom. Innate means inborn wisdom. He was very wise and intelligent person and a true generosity of spirit. He had an ideal helpmate. He's calling an ideal helpmate to his mother, whose name was Ashiyamma. And he tells about his mother that there would be people coming at their place daily, and he doesn't even remember that how many people she had fed in one single day. I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. So APJ Abdul Kalam says that she used to feed people every day more than the family members of their own family. So she was a very kind lady. We can make out from it. I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks, born to tall and handsome parents. So he's written that his parents were tall and handsome, and he was a short boy but very similar to his parents. They lived in their ancestral house, their grandparents, their great-grandparents' house, which was built in the 19th century. So their ancestral house was built in the middle of the 19th century. There at that time it was a pakka house. Though at that time only few people had pakka house made of limestone and brick, they had it and were on the Moss Street in Rameswaram. My Austria father, Austria means simple, strict and severe. His father did not like the luxuries in essential comforts at all. He would be avoiding all these in essential comforts and luxuries. Though APJ Abdul Kalam and his families had all the necessities, all his necessities were fulfilled, whether it was food, medicine or clothes. He says that he had a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally, because his parents were very supportive to all of them. Next page. The Second World War broke out in 1939 when I was 8 years old. So when the Second World War broke out in 1939, APJ Abdul Kalam was just 8 years old. That time there was a sudden demand of tamarind seeds in the market. Tamarind, what you call in Hindi is imli. So there was a sudden demand of tamarind seeds in the market when he was just 8 years old. And at that age, what he would do? He used to collect the seeds and sell them to a provision shop on Mosque Street. So he would collect those tamarind seeds and would sell them to a provision store on Mosque Street. And a day's collection, his day's earning would give him 1 anna, and that is equal to 6 paise. He had brother-in-law whose name was Jalaluddin. That time there were a lot of stories of the Second World War. There were fights going on, so they had a lot of stories at that time. So APJ Abdul Kalam would listen the stories of World War II from his brother-in-law Jalaluddin. And later he would find the same news in Deenamani. Deenamani is the local newspaper, is the name of a local newspaper. Like we have here is Hindustan Times, Dainik Jagran, the Times of India. So they had this Deenamani. It's a local newspaper, maybe in Tamil language. Our area being isolated was completely unaffected by the war. So where they lived in the Mosque Street in Rameswar, it was quite an isolated place. Not the main region where the Second World War was taking place, where Second World War has had an effect. So their area was completely unaffected by the World War II. But soon India was forced to join the Allied forces and something like a state of emergency was declared. The first casualty came in the form of the suspension of the train halt at Rameswaram station. So that time, whole India, the people of India were forced to join the Allied forces for the World War, and it was declared a state of emergency. Everything was stopped, and the first stoppage that came at that time was that their train at the Rameswaram station. So there was a sudden stoppage of the train at their Rameswaram station. Now, that time, he had his cousin named Samsuddin. What was the work of Samsuddin? Samsuddin would be distributing newspapers in the Rameswaram area. And he would be coming, he would obviously be using the train for the accommodation, for transportation. And then there was sudden train halt, and due to this, because no train was allowed to stop at the Rameswaram station, so this distribution of the newspaper that was being done by his cousin Samsuddin, he needed a helping hand that time. So he told APJ Abdul Kalam to help him to catch the bundles from the train. He would be throwing the bundle from the train at the Rameswaram station. APJ Abdul Kalam would be present there at the station, catching the bundles and then distributing it in the Rameswaram area. that time he earned his first wage. I can still feel the surge of pride in earning my own money for the first time. So students, I know you will not be able to understand this because you are too small, you are in this class 9, but when you will become an adult, when you will start earning the first salary you will have in your hand, you will have in your account, the feel of pride, the strong feeling of pride will fill your heart, your soul. You are going to be remembering the first salary whole your life. So similarly, the same feeling had filled APJ Abdul Kalam's heart because he had earned his first wage. And who helped him to earn his first wage? It was Samsuddin, his own cousin. Every child is born with inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. We all are living in our families. We have our own neighborhood. We have our own surroundings. And those surroundings affects us in a number of ways. We have our friends. We have our nearby family. We call them family as well. Whenever there is some function, whenever there is some party, they come to our place, we go to their places. So we have formed some kind of socio-economic and emotional environment around us. And we get to learn, we inherit a lot of things from our own house, from our own family, from our relatives, and also from our own surroundings. So here also, APJ Abdul Kalam says that he and his brothers and sisters had inherited a lot of things from his parents. What were the main things that they inherited? Inherited honesty and self-discipline from his father. And from their mother, they inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness. So, all the three brothers and sisters, APJ Abdul Kalam, had inherited honesty and self-discipline from their father and goodness, faith in goodness and deep kindness from their mother. So these were the inherited characteristics that they inherited from their parents. They also had, APJ Abdul Kalam also had his three close friends named Ramanatha Sastri, Arvindam and Shiv Prakasan. All the three boys belonged to Orthodox Brahmin family. Orthodox means who follow old traditions. As children, as you already know that APJ Abdul Kalam belonged to a Tamil Muslim family and his friends belonged to Orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. But during their childhood, as children, they never felt any kind of difference amongst themselves. They studied together, they played together, they would spend time together, they would even visit each other's houses also. They never felt any differences among themselves based on their religious differences or by the upbringing from by the parents. Ramanatha Sastri, who was Ramanatha Sastri? Ramanatha Sastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshmana Sastri, the high priest of the Rameswaram temple. So who was Ramanatha Sastri? Ramanatha Sastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshmana Sastri. And who was he? He was the high priest of the Rameswaram temple at that time. And when Pakshi Lakshmana Sastri got retired, this position was taken by Ramanatha Sastri himself. And he took the responsibility, took over the priesthood of the Rameswaram temple. Arvindam went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims, and Shiv Prakasan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways. So now, Arvindam, when became an adult, he went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims. A lot of pilgrims would be visiting Rameswaram place and the temples there. So he would be arranging transport for them. He went into the business of transportation. And Siv Prakasan became the catering contractor for the Southern Railways. He became the contractor and would be serving his department is would be serving food at the Southern Railways. He would take contract for the Southern Railways in the catering business. During the annual Sri Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, our family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of the Lord from the temple to the marriage site. Now, APJ Abdul Kalam tells about their business. What they would do is, during the annual Sri Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, his family would be arranging boats with a special platform in the boat for carrying idols of the Lord, and that boat would start from the temple to the marriage site, and this marriage site was situated in the middle of the pond called Ram Tirtha, and this place was near his house. He had grown up listening to the events of Ramayana and the life of the prophet. Prophet is a person who is sent by God to teach the people and give them messages from God. Were the bedtime stories my mother and grandmother would tell the children in our family. So he had grown up listening to the stories of Ramayana, the life of prophet, from his mother and from his grandmother both. So this is just the first part. I'm going to finish up here this tutorial till paragraph 5. I want you to read this lesson. Underline the difficult words, write their meanings on the top of the word so that it becomes easy for you to understand the lesson. And when you read it yourself, you're going to enjoy. Thank you.